facilitation mentorship program over the last few months. So this is main gig. I'll let you give yourself a little more of an in-depth introduction, but yeah, hope everybody's ready. And thank you for coming out.
All right, thank you. Give it up to Caleb. He's so loud. Thank you. I really love the vision and the mission of EntheoBreath and what Caleb and Jules are doing. So I just think it's a phenomenal job to put all of this together, and it takes a lot. So I just wanted to show some love to you guys, and thank you to Dr. Bordeaux and everybody out there. Well, you probably already know me. If you don't, my name's Ankhara Akeru, the Ankh Alchemist. And tonight I'm going to be sharing with you transformational breath workshop. And if you have never done anything like this, and this is totally new to you, this is not just like a 10-minute Wim Hof breath. This is a breath workshop that is going to actively release the endogenous DMT within your system. Okay, so this is like serious work. This is sympathetic breath work. So there's a slight difference between, there's actually a big difference between sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system, right? And so the parasympathetic nervous system, as some of you may know, is more of the rest, relax, digest, sleepy time kind of vibe. And that's important when we need that, we need to get that rest and we need to, be in a calm and safe space. And then there's those other times when we go into this sympathetic, active breathing. And this basically induces that, what they call fight or flight or freeze. There's a lot of different things they throw in there, but essentially it's the active, it's like the, oh shit, I gotta take action, I gotta do something right now. So this particular breath work is focused on the sympathetic nervous system side, so it's gonna really activate a lot of things. We're gonna be going in for, we're gonna be doing this breath technique for 60 minutes. So I'm gonna give this short little intro to the work, but just so you know, and just so you can prepare yourself, I want to let you know, this isn't just a 10-minute breath workshop. We're going to be really going deep, and we're going to be letting go of blockages, limiting beliefs, and really doing some deep work together. So
make sure that everybody has their bubble really spread out.
So I'm going to give a short little intro to the work so that everybody's familiar with what we're going to be doing, and then we're just going to dive right in. So appreciate you all for being here and taking time out of your busy lives and, with your families or away from your families, to come out here and commune, for this higher purpose of education and networking and bringing psychedelics and entheogens into a broader community and really spreading the awareness and the connection that we have in this mycelial network. I'm doing this because breathwork changed my life. My first breakthrough breathwork experience was actually during the birth of my daughter. I have a 13-year-old daughter, and before she was born, when she was conceived, her mother and I decided to do an unassisted at-home birthing. So we planned from the beginning to not have a midwife in the picture, not have a doula. It was just gonna be her and I. And it's a really potent, powerful way to bring a child into this life, let me tell you. Because when you create that life, right, you're in that intimate, quiet space, soft lighting, maybe some music and things like that. That's how you wanna bring the child into this world as well. And so during the birthing of my daughter, of course, we had been practicing Lamaze breathing, which is the typical type of breath work that you do for pregnancy, right? And so during the birthing of my daughter, we were starting to get into that Lamaze breathing. I was actually practicing former partner. And with the plan and vision for the birthing was like, went like this, me here in between the legs catching the baby, right? So all fathers imagine, I guess. But it didn't happen like that. So the mother of the child was having a lot of pain and struggles inside of the tub that she was in. So I had to jump in with her and support her from behind, like lift her up with my arms so that she wouldn't sink down into the water. And during this, you know, this progression of the birth and during the actual crowning of my daughter, I went into this deep state, right? Because I was doing this like intense breathing. And then she came through the portal, and I remember seeing her, and she wasn't breathing, you know. And this is, of course, natural, but a child doesn't breathe the first breath for the first few moments, you know. But in those moments, I found myself clenching my breath, and I did like a full breath retention, because like I was waiting for her to breathe, and I was just like, breathe, just breathe, you know. Like, it's that moment of like, oh my gosh, she's not breathing, you know. And in that moment of holding my breath, I went into this deep visionary state, and I saw this light being emanated from the womb of the mother where my child was. And this light had a thread or a cord that extended out and connected to my mother, who was there at the birth as well. She actually acted as a doula. And so my mother was there to catch her, and I saw this thread connecting her to my mother, and then this thread of light continued all the way back, all the women, all the grandmothers and grandmothers' grandmothers, all the way back to the beginning of creation. And in that moment, I understood the power of the feminine, you know, this birth giving, this life giving energy. And in that moment, it was just this full-on breakthrough psychedelic experience, and I didn't take anything. I think I smoked a herb that morning, but aside from that, no psychedelics. And it just put me in this space of just pure humbleness to the feminine and how much strength it takes to give birth, right? So, you know, big respect to all the mothers and soon-to-be mothers and all the feminine energies out here and out there for bringing, you know, the future generations into this world. But that was my breakthrough experience with the breath work, and then I realized how powerful and potent it was. So that's why I'm here sharing this with you, because it changed my life, and I trust that if you fully surrender to this process and you go in, that it will be groundbreaking for you as well. So, to have this life-breaking experience, this breakthrough experience, I'm going to need you all to like lean into this and really do the work. So this is on you. You know, I'm going to be guiding you through the process, and I'm going to be coaching you along. But it's really up to you to do the breath work, and that's all you'll need to focus on for this whole time is your breath. Okay. And it may bring up some discomforts, discomforts, and some, you know, some things. The intentions for this is for you to decide. So right now, I would like you to start thinking about what your intention for this breathwork session is going to be. For me, it's all about letting go. My intention is to be here and to be your guide and to make sure that everybody's safe and goes through this experience safely together. And I would like you to choose your intention for this breathwork, just like you would choose your intention for, you know, a psychedelic journey. So go ahead and start thinking about that and why you want to do that. But it's going to really take some work to push through the discomforts and things that are going to come up for you during this session. There's three things that you're going to need to know about this breathwork. It's going to bring up to things physically, so you may experience a tingling sensation in your hands and feet. You also may experience what's called tetany. It's a technical term, but it's like the lobster claw when your hands lock up. I know some of the men that are directing that you work all day with tools. At the end of the day, when you go to sleep, your hands are like locked like this. this may happen during the, and this is normal. This is going to, you know, it's going to be a part of the experience, and it'll go away as soon as you come back to your normal breathing. So, you know, you're not like having a medical issue or anything like that. Just want to get ahead of time. You might get lightheaded and dizzy, you know. You might feel like you're going to pass out, but we're all going to start out laying down if you're going to do the work and do mass or request that you're on the ground, lying down, so that if you do like pass out or something happens, you don't fall over in your head. Emotionally, things are going to come up for you. Don't push them down. That's the whole point of this breath work session, is to bring things up into the full view, you know, and face some of these things. So a lot of the trauma and a lot of the things, the blocks that we have are generational, intergenerational trauma. It didn't even begin with us. It's not even our back to carry, but we're, you know, for some reason, got sent back on the shoulders going up the mountain. So this is going to give you an opportunity to put those bags aside and realize that that shit wasn't even yours to begin with. That was maybe your ancestor's ancestor shit. But, you know, it's not up to you to necessarily continue to carry that burden. So the breath work is the doorway to the subconsciousness. And we're going to get into, you know, some of the things as far as what that physically does and scientifically does. But it's definitely going to switch your from your conscious mind to your subconscious mind, essentially. So it's basically, it's your responsibility to do this work. It's your responsibility to show up in this time and do the work for your future generations, so that they are not carrying your bullshit bags as well. So those are some of the things emotionally that may come up for you. If you feel like you need to cry, shake, or move, it's totally welcome in this space. You're in a safe space, and that is a lot of times what is going to happen to you. You're going to feel like you need to cry or you need to move or something. Totally welcome and safe to do in this space. And then, let's see, we're in physical, emotional, mental. Okay, so here's where we get into the transient hypofrontality, which is a fancy medical term for the front part of your brain is the prefrontal cortex, right? And this is where what they call the monkey mind. This is where all the chatter, all the bullshit, and all the, you know, stories are like running around loose in your head. This is the prefrontal cortex. This is the monkey mind. So when we're doing this work, what it does is actually within about 5 minutes of doing this, it's going to switch that off like a light switch. Literally, your whole prefrontal cortex is going to switch off. You will have no more of that mental chatter and no more of the looping thoughts and things that are running around in your mind. So you're going to be able to really focus in on the breath work. You might get distracted as you're doing this breath work, and like you're gonna think about, you know, your laundry list of shit to do, or where you're going tomorrow, or whatever's happening. That's going to happen, but it's, you know, the whole point of this breath work session is to really like push through that and work through that with the breath. So if those things come up for you, your tool is the breath. So no matter what, we're going to come back to that breathing. If you find yourself, you need to reset your breath for a minute, or you find yourself not breathing in the same pattern, just take a few moments, reset your breath, and then go back into it. So it's going to be a very active breath work. So you can get off track and just bring your mind back. Just remind me, I'm going to be guiding you so you remember. I'm going to play some songs, some music that are going to be guiding the space as well. So we'll be, you know, have that for part of our journey. If you can change your breath, you can change your mind, right? So how we're breathing is how we're living. You find yourself, check in with yourself, you know, throughout the day, how your breathing is. There's a couple different ways. It's part of actually doing breath work. One of the shallow? You know, is it rapid? Is it kind of wonky? Are you taking deep breaths into your belly? Where are you at with your breath? These are some things to, you know, think about when you go through the day. How am I breathing? So if you start breathing better, you're going to feel better. Okay, so I'm going to go over the technique just real quick, and then we'll be able to pretty much dive into the process. So check it out, man. This is what we're going to do. It's called holotropic breathwork. And this is a modality that was advanced by Stanislav Grof. He did 10 years of research and study in a clinic with LSD. And through that process of doing these studies, he actually created a way to reach these transient, non-ordinary states of consciousness with the breath. And so this is known as holotropic breathing. This is towards wholeness, holotropic. So this breath work, if you've never experienced it, it's going to be a three-part breath. So what we're going to do is, on the first part of the breath, this is going to be three parts, okay? The first part of the breath, we're going to breathe into the belly. So if everyone wants to put your hand on your stomach, so you can feel your stomach expand as you take, you're going to take essentially a half breath. Half breath into your stomach, and then a half breath into your chest. So the full breath will be starting in the belly, and then the next in the chest. Okay, that's for your inhale. Now your exhale is going to be a passive exhale. So it's going to be letting go of the breath and letting it fall away and recede out of your body. So you're not pushing or forcing the breath. You're just the active inhale, that is going to be an active part of it. And then the passive part is the breath release or the exhale. So if you want it, I'll just take a moment or two to get familiarize yourself with that breath technique. So let's go ahead and take one part breath into the belly, one into the chest, and then release, let it go. Again, one into the belly, one into the chest, and release. Good. Okay, so I think that you've all got it. It's pretty basic and straightforward. Now, the other part is we're going to be doing a breath retention. This is where it gets really good. This is where we release the endogenous DMT, and it gets really tricky. So at one point in this session, I'm going to be guiding you to hold your breath and retain your breath for 1 minute. I know that sounds like a lot, but you can all do it. If you can't, it's fine. Go ahead and release the breath and keep going. But I'm going to ask you to do your best to hold your breath for 1 minute. And I'm going to be timing that here on the side, so you don't have to worry about, you know, actually keeping time. Is everybody comfortable with the actual breath work that we're going to be doing, the technique? Is everybody comfortable with that? Anybody who doesn't understand, raise your hand. All right, excellent. Okay, so your intention is very important. I just wanted to remind you of that. This session, again, is going to be about letting go of whatever you might be holding on to. So I'm going to be guiding you with prompts to take action. And then the last part, so there's gas and brakes. During this session, we're going to start out with slow and low. We're going to just create a pace for ourselves, and it's going to be slow. And we're going to warm up for about 5 to 8 minutes as we do this breath work. Then, as we get into it deeper, I'm going to challenge you, and I'm going to push you to breathe a little bit faster. Pick up your rate. Put the gas on, if you will. Now, at any point, just know that you have a break as well, and you can push the brakes if you need to. But I'm going to tell you that the harder you push and the more you dive into this, the more breakthrough experience you're going to have, I promise. So if you really want to get the work in, much and it's overwhelming, put the brakes on, slow it down a little bit. And if you need to just come out of it, just breathe for a few moments, reset yourself, that's fine too. Everybody feeling good? Everybody comfortable? Yeah? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my man Caleb over here, who's going to help hold the container. Some things might come up for you guys, as I mentioned. You know, this is going to be intense work. So we're going to have a couple people posted at the doors and around the room that are going to help. Danielle is going to help us as well. I appreciate that, Danielle. And other than that, I think we're going to turn it out yet. Oh yeah, you can turn the lights down. That'd be great. So let's just go ahead and I'll start out taking three reset breaths. Let's go ahead and take a deep breath in. The biggest breath you've had all day. Deep breath in. And release with a sigh. Ah. That's good, right? Deep breath in. And release with a sigh. Slow and low, we're going to take one half breath into the belly, into the chest, and release. The belly, chest, release. Belly, chest, release. Good. And just keep going, find that base. You're going to be doing this on your own here, and we'll guide you through. But just find your own pace, three breaths in, one breath out. Try to keep your breath connected here. Don't pause in between your breath. One continual breath there. Thank you. keep going. You got it perfect.
Thank you.
showing up for yourself. Most people are not doing that. Keep going. Congratulate yourself. You're doing the work. All the way in. Keep reading.
You guys.
tingling, feel the pulsation in your body. How does that feel in your core? Keep holding. Feel that. Feel that down in the core of your body. Embody this moment. 15 seconds. When we let go of this breath, I want you to let it all go. Scream, cry, let anything out that you need to let go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let it all go.
Forgive others.
stop, family. Don't fall off. Keep breathing. Keep resting. Don't rest out. Showing up for yourself. Good job. Trying to commit yourself to bad decisions, your so-called mistakes, things that didn't work out, maybe somebody that hurt you. Have to let it go, family. Good.
Yes.
focus on the breath. Nothing to do but to breathe. Keep going.
Matters, family. You are enough, you have enough, you do enough.
now with me in the journey. Bring your spirit and your awareness back into your crown. For being here, be present with yourselves, and doing this work. It means a lot to me that you all are showing up and being present for yourself. Hopefully you see that. So I want to let you all know as well that I do offer this as a container in my work, and I am certified transformational. Well, if you weren't awake before, now you are. Welcome back, everybody. We are here now. All right, so I just wanted to let you all know that if you appreciated that, you enjoyed it, you got something out of it, and you want to